Hello friends, welcome to NestorOps. In this video, we're going to discuss that how to set up an Ubuntu server for the Ansible installation. So what is an Ansible? So Ansible is a simple, agentless and powerful open source IT automation tool, which provides you the provisioning, configuration management, application deployment, continuous delivery, security and compliance, and orchestration kind of services. So it is basically, it is an open source tool and it doesn't require any agent to install on your device, and it is a very powerful tool and very easy to use. Now we'll jump into our practical. So now we have to set up the Ubuntu server to install the Ansible. So this is my EC2 Ubuntu instance and I'm already logged in into it. So now before starting the settings, to we have to do before the Ansible installation. So before that, we'll be gaining the root access by sudo su. So okay, now we have logged in as root. Now we'll be updating the packages. Now the packages are, as you can see, the packages has been installed now. So now we'll be starting with the steps now. So firstly, we'll be creating a new user. And to create a new user, we are using this command add user ansible. So what this command says is that we are adding a user here. And the name, we are giving the name to our user as Ansible. So it is very important to add any user, because to use a tool, if you have a user, then you will be logging into your tool through that user, and it will be secure and easy to access that tool. Right. So okay, now we'll go through this. So now. Now it is asking for a new password to enter. So I'm entering the password. Now you can see it is asking for to enter the new value or press enter for the default. So if you want to keep any name, if you want to write any name here, so you can write it, but I'm pressing it the enter for keeping as default. So now it's asking, is the information correct? So I'm giving in the confirmation as Y. Yes. Okay, now as we have added a user successfully. Now what we'll do next is we'll grant the administrative privileges to our user which we just created. So what it will do is it will allow our normal user to run commands with the administrative privileges by putting the word sudo before each command. So we'll be giving the administrative privileges by copying this command. So this is the user mod. This command says is user modification -ag and sudo. This is the name of the user which we created as Ansible. Okay. So the administrative privileges to our user which we just created has been set up. Now after the giving the privileges, what we'll be doing is we'll be setting up a basic firewall. So now Ubuntu 18.04 servers can use the UMW firewalls to make sure only connections to certain services are allowed. So now we'll be copying this command ufw app list. Now it will show the available applications right now, which is the open SSH. So now to set up a basic firewall, what we'll do is we'll allow the open SSH. So we'll copy it. Now ufw allow open SSH. So as you can see, the rules are updated here. So it's rules updated, and these rules are for v6 version also. Now what we'll do is we'll be enabling the firewall. So to enable the firewall, there is this command ufw enable. So the firewall is active and enabled on system startup. Now what we'll be checking the status of our firewall setup. So here you can see that this open SSH is being allowed. This is the firewall which is being allowed. The action is allowed from anywhere. So friends, in this video, what we did is we tried to set up an Ubuntu server to install the Ansible on it further. So firstly we have logged in as root, then we created a new user. Then we have granted and given the administrative permissions or privileges to the user we created. After that, we have set up the basic firewall on our Ubuntu, and we have enabled the firewall and we have checked the status. So this was the status. So friends, that's all for this lecture. Thank you.